to a nightclub. You're going to work. Like, you imagine just like you rocking your stuff. Yeah, okay? No, 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 no. Okay? You're here to work. It's a professional environment. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. And my name is Tumi, and this is The Power Closet. So for those of you who are new, I started this channel not too long ago as a way to build a community of women where we can discuss all things work related. So from fashion, as in workwear, to also life at work. So today I'm coming at you with 10 things to help you build a bomb ass closet. This is my perspective, of course. Happy for you to comment below and tell me what you think, if it's a yay or if it's a nay, and other things you think are essential to building a closet. So I think I was scrolling on Instagram not too long ago and I saw that someone was literally like, your work closet is an investment into your career. And I'm like, I don't mean go and invest your life savings in there, okay, that's a bit ridiculous, but I 101% agree. I think how you look really influences people's perception of you, so it's so important you manage that well. But we're not going to go into too much detail because if you follow me on Instagram, we're going to be having chats about that ever so often, but we're going to jump right into the video. So the first thing I think is super essential are good staples. I know some firms tend to be very strict on color code, so I think something that's really good are good staples. So be it a very good dress that is blue, navy, black, that fits perfectly, as well as a good skirt and good trousers. So the one I'm going to be modeling on the left or right here is one I picked up from Warehouse. It's quite flattering. It fits very, very well. I actually didn't alter this. It came just like this. And I've just worn it simply and paired it with like my favorite hosiery from Calzedonia. It's quite hard for me to find a good skirt that works. So here I paired like a navy blue skirt with just a simple knit top, and it's simple, classy, and elegant. When it fits your body structure well, it just looks a lot more flattering on. Okay, so the second thing I think is essential has to be staple knitwear. So my sister always teases me that I'm perpetually cold, as in I'm always cold. I don't know if it's because I'm actually originally Nigerian and I don't know what's the coldest Nigeria gets, maybe like 20 degrees. In England, I'm literally always freezing. But that's not the point. I say staple knitwear because knitwear, whether it's light or thick, is just such an elegant and easy way to just spice out an outfit. So in the video, I'm going to be modeling like a white knit top I got from H&M. This probably cost me nothing more than £15 or so. I think if you're not in a corporate setting, so let's say you work for a tech firm, if you work for a slightly casual office, right? You just want something really comfortable, something really easy that you can just throw on and still look good. So if you just put on a really well-made jumper, I'll put some that are on my wish list on the side right now, and some really nice trousers or culottes, you could just look very elegant and very nice. I think knitwear, especially when it's light colored as opposed to dark colored, is very, very classy and it can be reused and worn under lots of items. Third thing is, I'm going to term this one dresses that don't bail on you. And I think a dress for me is pretty much my go-to look when I'm going to the office. So I work in a pretty corporate setting, but it's not like you can only wear black, like it's quite flexible, right? I think dresses are so easy because the issue with two pieces, like a top or a trouser, is that you always have to find a way to pair it, and that's very irritating sometimes. I mean, I tend to gravitate towards wrap dresses because I think they're very flattering, they're elegant, they're beautiful. I think it's very important you have your like dresses that you have on repeat that perhaps isn't too obvious, And when I say repeats, please don't wear this five times a week, people will notice. I mean, like that dress where, okay, you get out of bed late and you know you want to look put together, you can just wear it and you still look good. That's what I mean by dresses that don't bail on you. I think it's also good to maybe get colors that you find attractive that are within your color palette. So if you know you're not someone that really likes color, it's probably not the best time to pick out a dress that is, you know, neon green or something. When I put this video together, I did it with the intention of how do you actually start building a closet? Because I remember when I was starting mine and boy, oh boy, I spent so much money and so much time like going everywhere trying to find something that looked sensible. One thing I think is super important are smart, elegant, and beautiful blouses. So I know, I think it's Hayes and Curtis. I'll put the link below and I'll put some pictures of me modeling one of my favorite tops from there, or two of my favorite tops. Or you can also go off like Vestiaire Collective and search for really beautiful blouses. So I remember I got this amazing one from Anne Fontaine that has ruffles all over it. And I think those kind of blouses with just simple trousers or simple skirts can simply elevate a look instantly. The fifth thing that I most definitely think is so important, this is not even specific to your work wardrobe, is outerwear. Outerwear, when you walk into a room, especially when it's cold in England, right? September is not even that cold. Let's say November, you walk into a room, the first thing someone sees is your coat. So let's think about this. If you wore a coat that had holes in it, a coat that was dirty, a coat that was scruffy, how do you think people would perceive you? Like, people just start making instant, you know, they just start thinking things instantly, and you really, really want to control that. You don't have to have like a Burberry trench, even though it's really nice. I think the one I'm modeling now is a blazer. I had this on my wish list from Another Stories, and even me sometimes, I really, really think it through before I pull the trigger for certain items. But then this went on sale and I had to buy it immediately. I think it's so beautiful. A trench coat elevates an outfit. Like, you can be wearing a black top, black trousers, you wear a really nice trench coat, and instantly you look a lot more classy. I think it's just the little things that can make a huge difference. But when you think about, oh, I can just wear this coat, just think about it from this perspective. It's the first thing that they see before they see the outfit under. Please avoid picking coats that are awful colors. My point is, pick a coat that is a neutral color and is very, very wearable. So number six would be really good work shoes. Personally, I think good work shoes are so important. Now, we can go, this can be an entire video, and perhaps one day it will be, but for now I'm going to keep it short and simple. You probably want to look at shoes that are you know, light colored or neutral colored, so a black, a nude, a navy blue, something that is wearable. Because think about it, if you're going to spend a lot of money on perhaps a designer shoe, you don't want to, like, I wouldn't want to buy like orange, or like, I don't know, I personally wouldn't buy like orange shoes if I'm going to work, just because it's very hard for me to wear that over and over again. Secondly, this is a debate I've had with so many people. Heel height. If I'm working 9 till God knows when, you probably don't want to be rocking up in, I don't know, 11cm shoes. First of all, I think it can just send off the wrong signal. But I think something that is quite manageable are like heel heights below 9.5. I personally don't like going anything above 9.5, and even 9.5 for me, as in cm, is a lot. Most comfortable shoes are hands down the GMB Torossi Anna 85s. They are the best shoes I've ever gotten. I definitely got them from like Net-a-Porter or something. In terms of black ones, they're the Christian Louboutin's Claire 80 in black patent leather. Two favorite go-tos, but I also have another affordable pair from Mango. You don't want to be wearing stilettos. Like, you're not going to a nightclub, you're going to work. Like, imagine just like you rocking your stuff. Yeah. Okay, no. Okay, you're here to walk. It's a professional environment. Look, that's not even going to be. My point is, keep it below 11, keep it below 9.5 at most. Perhaps you're in a not so corporate environment. loafers, like really lovely loafers. I got these beautiful loafers last week and I can't wait to like style them. Really good loafers, flats, like it's so important to have nice flats. I'm quite conscious of the fact that I'm always modeling most of my stuff with heels. These are simple flats, my flats that I wear on the tube, wear to work, wear when I don't want to wear heels. And I think they're so pretty. I have, like, ASOS will probably do some. I will link a few below, like all sorts of options. But these are ways you can look very classy when you don't want to wear heels. Another thing that definitely elevates your whole work look would be good bags. I'm gonna be carrying a bag to walk around work, right? You're gonna carry a bag when you get in and when you're leaving. But still, I think it just makes, it makes me as an individual feel a lot more put together when everything matches. Do you understand what I mean? Let's say you feel good, your dress looks good, your coat looks good, and then you now have that hideous bag. No. It's just like train wreck. No, okay? Everything has to be well put together in the right proportions. First bag I'll be talking about is this one. So I got this bag. It's a simple leather bag, very, very beautiful quality. It's brand new, it's super deep. So obviously it fits like, it will fit like my laptop, probably like my trainers just before I like go to the gym, my change of clothes, my hairbrush, all sorts of stuff. Like you want a bag that actually fits a lot of things. It's from Another Stories. It's just simple leather, but I really like it because it looks like such high quality. I got that off Depop for £30. Exactly. I think it looks a lot more expensive than £30. And if you throw this on your outfit, it just elevates everything. It just completes it all. And I love that. You don't want people to be confused. They'll be wondering, why is her bag like that? If you have a bit more coins, perhaps you can get like another like bag. So this is a Chanel GST. This is another work bag that I use from time to time, but I personally love the GST for keeping a lot of stuff. Now number eight, the last and final thing, which again could be another whole video, is hosiery or hosiery, whichever way it's said. I probably butchered the name, but you know what, you get my point. So I live in England, and England has a culture for wearing tights. Now, I personally do not really like tights because I find them very, very uncomfortable. One that matches my height, my figure, is very, very difficult, which is why I completely scrapped tights and now I wear hold-ups. Now, I say it's important for your look because personally, I've noticed that while working, you'd be hard pressed to find somebody that doesn't wear them, especially if you work in a very corporate place. Most women do. As in, it's just, and now it's almost like, it's almost impossible for me to wear an outfit and not put it on. I think it just makes everything look clean, put together, and little things are things that matter and really make a difference. You know what? I don't want to wear it. It's too hot. It's very uncomfortable. And if that's you, absolutely fine. No biggie. It's just my opinion. That's it. 8 things. I know I said 10, but yeah, sorry. It's just 8 things. I think what I will say that is super important is planning. So if you're trying to look a bit more genge or a bit more interesting, start with light colors, build your way up, starting to add color gradually. If you're just starting out, it makes no sense whatsoever to go and buy all orange tops, green shoes, purple, like, I don't really know what you're gonna achieve with that. Probably buy colors that you can wear lots and lots and lots of times. And yeah, those are my tips, 8 tips. Let me know what you think. Comment below. Let me know if you thought that I left out anything. And thank you very much for watching. We'll be bringing you more fashion tips and tricks. And then over time, we will add in more stuff into the power closet. Bye, guys. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Just please. Bye.